Alright, what's up guys? So this is going to be the How to Get Any Enchant You Want guide. I've been seeing some people gatekeeping the hell out of this guide, but you already know, I've got you guys on the tutorial. So the first thing you're going to want to do is be experienced at running floor 1. This does actually take some time, and you do have to complete floor 1 along with doing a side quest, and you have to complete both of them in the same run, alright? So, that's why you're probably going to want to be a lot more experienced. You're probably going to want to have a teammate, someone who can run to the end and teleport you to the boss like I did in this video. As you can see, I'm running it with one of my guild members. But he's going to get the key, you're going to see it there. And I'm going to speed up this footage. If you want to know how to get to the generator boss, or if you want to know how to complete the first floor of layer 2, you're probably going to want to watch my other video on the layer 2 guide on the best layer 2 guide video. But either way, here's the sped up footage.
Alright, so I'm also going to explain some of what you're going to see in the sped up footage here. You can see right here I'm taking the normal path, it's like avoiding the wind, avoid getting blown off. There's actually a piece of gale wax in that cave, but we're not going to pay attention to that. You're going to see me kill the monster here. And then once I do this, the actual tutorial starts. So, right here, you're actually going to find your first piece of gale wax. Alright, now you can get the one back in the cave over there, but I just prefer this order. It feels a lot faster, I guess. So you want to pick up that piece of gale, you want to start the generator, and then you're going to want to drop down, and here, I'll speed up to the cave real quick. So we can build a playground. Alright, so now that we're at the cave, you're going to want to jump over, you're going to want to grab that gale wax right there, and then you're going to want to head over to the first lamp site. So pretty much you're running through this like normally right now, so I'll go ahead and speed this up as well. Alright, so now you're just going to want to follow the path that I take, and you're just going to go about it like usual. Your friend should be somewhere around the end, or like running during the run. You're going to want to pick up the gale wax right here like normal. Now, this part is a little bit confusing, but I'm not going to make any cuts. This is how you get the journals, okay? So if you're looking to just get the journals, light hook out, you're going to want to follow what I'm doing right now. Alright, so pretty much what I'm about to show you here is another gale wax location, but right here, I just missed the diver. That diver on the floor there, if you talk to him, he gives you a diver journal, alright? So you're going to want to talk to him. We're going to end up circling back in the footage because, like I said, I just completely forgot. I recommend you can follow the path that I take here for it to be the least confusing, because if you try and like judge on your own, you might make a mistake and you might end up getting lost. But overall, you're going to want to start like hugging the right side. That's generally a good way to do it. I actually took a wrong turn here. So you're not going to want to do that because there are two NPCs that will spawn and try to fight you, which is never good. But yeah, you're just going to want to stick along the right side, and then eventually you'll come to this entrance right here. There will be this journal on this rock right here. You're going to want to talk to that. Don't die to the carbuncles. I just ran away from them here. And then right here, I believe this is where I realized that I actually forgot the other journal. So I just went straight forward, right, and, you know, I still made a mistake in finding this. But I ended up finding the place where you get the Ignition Union Hook Talent, and I decided, you know, might as well go ahead and touch the lantern, clear off some of my parasites. So that's what you're going to see here. This is also a good place to, like, reorient yourself. So if you are lost and you need to get back, it's a good place for you to start off again if you had to pause the video or anything. But yeah, you're going to see me go out, and right here you're also going to see me go along this path. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the Furfire Caverns. I'm going to avoid that hook, but that hook is important, all right? So you're going to want to remember that. But I just go back to the Furfire Cavern so that you guys can have a good reference, because I noticed that I kind of messed up pretty bad. I just didn't want to really do this again, because, you know, if I go up, I'd have to run on a 10-minute light hook, and that's, you know, just not a good idea. But you're just going to want to follow this route that I take, and it's literally straight back to the first, or to the second piece of Gale Wax that I showed you guys. But this time I'm going to show you the dialogue with the dead diver NPC. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk to him. As you can see, that's the dialogue options. I'm going to head back. I'm going to go ahead and speed up here because... Actually, no, I'm not. So right here is where you're going to want to take this hook up from that NPC. Some wind will be blowing at you. The wind direction actually varies. I don't know why, it's kind of buggy here. But now that you have all of your Gale Wax, and this is for the people that are trying to do this in all one run, you're gonna wanna come over here, and I'm just gonna speed up, like, you know, traveling through this wind, and then I'll continue my explanation. All right, so while this part is sped up, you want to be careful on crossing this bridge. The wind blows frequently, and you're going to want to press E on all the candles. With the Gale Wax, you should be able to light all the candles, so you're good to go. There are lanterns in here, as you can see, and you can reset your parasites with those. I open these chests, and I find an enchant stone. I find a Tears Eden Kite, I think is what it was called. And then I just loot all the other chests, but pretty much you can find legendary weapons. I think you can find any legendary weapon in those artifact chests. You can also find enchant stones, but that's the gist of it. I had my friend TP me to the boss fight. I will show you the boss fight at the end of the video, but I'm also going to insert the third book location right here. Alright, so now that you're looking at this, you can see where you could go if you wanted to get all of the stuff in the candle place and then go find it. I took a shortcut in this clip, but you can still get here, you know, just taking the first route that I showed you right at the start of the video. And pretty much, I'm going to go ahead and cut back to where I'm coming back up into the lantern place. So let me go ahead and do that right here. And this is where you're going to go ahead and start walking back. You're gonna see in this clip that I actually end up jumping off. I was just wondering if I could take this shortcut because I kind of hate, you know, climbing up, waiting for the wind and stuff like that. But you're just gonna wanna go up this hook, or you're gonna wanna go the normal route actually. I don't know if you guys have builds that will allow you to take that shortcut. As you can see, I just take the traditional route. I actually do jump down early because I have a Gale build. And then now that you're at the Furfire Caverns, you're just gonna wanna see, you're just gonna wanna follow what I do. Like I said, if you've watched my guide, you know what I'm doing. So I'm gonna go up, I'm gonna talk to the NPC up top, open up the door, and the third book location is inside of the blooper run or whatever. I don't know what you call them, the chomper run. All right, so you're gonna see me clear my parasites right here, and you're gonna see me go up and talk to them. I'm gonna keep this part in just in case some of you guys don't really know this part yet, because I know some of you guys are a little confused about navigating the Furfire Caverns at the moment. So if you guys aren't as experienced but you still want to follow along, I'm gonna go ahead and keep this in. You have to have the spear already unlocked to do what I just did there. I didn't include that in my first guide video because that was me assuming that all of you guys have never done the spear before. But you can skip the spear. If you don't have the spear, you're gonna need to go back to my other guide and you're gonna need to get the spear to be able to skip in future runs like that. But now this is where the good part starts. This is the last diver journal. And what you're gonna do is you're just gonna run through. There's gonna be a little hole in the wall on the left here. I actually pass it right here. It is actually really hard to notice, but I believe it's right there next, like literally right where I just looked in the clip. I realize I missed it, and I go back. I start getting, like, mollywopped by the goobers. But as you can see, there's that little hole in the wall. I kind of point out where it is more clearly. Talk to this diver, read the journal, and now you have the last of the journals. So, I light hook in that part of the clip, but this is where you're going to want to start fighting the boss. So, I'm going to go ahead and speed this up. Alright, and while you guys are watching me dance on Chase with my friend, right, I kind of want to clarify. So, pretty much the steps are in one run, right, get all of the wax, have all of the journals, open the wax room. You can loot the chest, or you don't have to. I didn't loot the chest when I got my stone or any enchant I want stone. So you don't actually have to open the chest. But then you're gonna want to go back up, right? You don't have to go to layer 2, 4, 2 or anything. And you're gonna want to come over and talk to this NPC. Now, I don't have the dialogue right here, but there's going to be a fourth dialogue option that's gonna say, here's what I found at the gale. You're gonna get this stone, and as you can see, you can pick from any of the enchants. You can literally put any enchant on any weapon, unless it's like legendary or something like that. But yeah, that's the video. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate all the support from you guys as well. Remember, the Railblade giveaway is in my Discord. I'll put the Discord link in the description below. It's going on for, I believe, two more days right now, or maybe it's one more day. Can't really remember. But if you enjoyed, please leave a like. Remember, tell your friends about the Railblade giveaway, and see you.